Hey guys, hi. I want to take a few minutes out to talk to you about somebody I was listening to and reading about the last week, and some fascinating insights about life that he's reiterated for me. And the person's name is Adam Robinson. Does a lot of things. You can look him up. I heard him on a Tim Ferriss podcast. I think this was podcast number 210. The show was brilliant. If you get a chance, please hear it out. It's a 2-hour, 1.5-hour episode called The Very Best Version of You. Now, some of the things, one of the questions posed to Adam was that if you give 3 pieces of advice to somebody, what would they be? And he articulated what was needed to be said very beautifully. Like it just made me feel alive. I was absolutely resonating with everything he was saying. The first one he said was, he talked about enthusiasm. And he said that, understand that life is happening for you. This life exists for you. It's not happening to you. It's not a disease that is happening to you. The whole life around you is for you. What you need to understand is that every single thing in life that you do, you have to do it with enthusiasm. You have to want to do it. And if you don't feel like it, you got to create that enthusiasm. If you want success in it, you will never ever get success in life if you don't put enthusiasm behind it. And it spoke to me so directly, because that's how my life is. Either, and this is something else somebody else said on another Tim Ferriss podcast. His name was Ron Sivers. I'm sorry. I will link the guys in the podcast later. He said that in life, when you are given a decision to make about something, you should do something or not. In my head, this is what I do. I think about it. If that idea is a hell yes, I'll do it. If it's not, I'm not going to do it. And that's a beautiful way to simplifying life. You don't have to do everything, unless, of course, it's a hell yes. And for the hell yes, get the enthusiasm going. For now, if you guys worry about studying exams and all of that stuff, and that's because my audience is mainly students, understand that the studying part might not be a hell yes. But then think about your goals, your careers. Are they a hell yes? If they're not, you got to change them. If they are, maybe you're doing that for family, so the family becomes a hell yes. So if it's a hell yes, then you gotta give it that enthusiasm. Because, and the other thing is, the reason is because you don't live alone. I mean, you're not sitting behind a desk all day, 10 hours a day. It is not that kind of job. Unless, of course, you want to be a freelancer, even then you have to go meet people. And the reason why I say enthusiasm is because people will feel your enthusiasm. People feed off that. The energy you will give to them, the transfer to them, that'll come out in the enthusiasm. So first thing I'll tell my kids is, and this is something I live by, absolutely. And at times I would not be doing something that was giving me enthusiasm or excitement or a hell yes. And I was like, you know what? Now I'll only do something if it's a hell yes. I'm too old now. I'm almost 40. I got a few years left. I want to only do things that are hell yes. And I'll tell you this also. Make your life more about the hell yes moments and do whatever you need to do with enthusiasm. You meet people, they feed off the enthusiasm that you will have. And it'll be contagious. People will have much more respect for you. You'll leave a much better impression on them. They will want to see you again. So, and somebody else said this, and I don't remember the name. Again, reiterating, some smart person. These are all things that somebody else has said. I'm just curating the content for you guys out there. One of the persons said that, you know, the effect you have on people is the most important or the strongest or the most valuable currency you have. So if you want to have that leverage or that advantage, leverage sometimes is not a positive word, but if you want to have an advantage in any relationship, you've got to treat that relationship or any encounter with that with full enthusiasm. And people will feed off that, and they will respect it, and they will want it, and they will want to meet you again and again and give you that respect. That's one. The second thing that was Adam had shared was that make connections. You can't live. He was a guy who used to live his life alone. He's a very smart guy who tended to live his life as a teacher and then a businessman and this and that in a very close circle. He didn't want to meet people. But the number of people doesn't matter, but as long as you understand that in your life, you need to connect with people. Living is connections with people. You can't live alone. There is no way in hell that you can go through life living by yourself, because living means to connect with people. And that's important, because when you connect with people, you connect with them with a smile, a hug, or just a laugh or a handshake. And that matters. Now, and you realize this, whenever you're miserable, generally it's because you don't have a friend to share that misery with or to just unload. But if you have that, the misery becomes a lot less painful to live with. And in this day and age of people having a lot of things that put their happy feels, pulls on their happy feels or makes them feel a little inadequate and not happy, you need to understand that it's that you need to make connections with people. You need to make a few very strong connections, and then they are always there for you in every regard. And if somebody is not genuine, you move to make a new connection. And right now, at your age, mostly, you guys are 18, 24s and all that, it's a perfect time to make connections. Meet new people. Just go up, be happy, be enthusiastic in that conversation. And a way to meet people is the third thing he mentioned, was that whenever you meet somebody, you got to expect magic. And I shared this on my Facebook a bit ago. And the quote was, and I'd like to read it out exactly, that if you expect magic in every moment, you are going to get it. And I absolutely, absolutely believe in that. It's like a much more cuter, more connected version of saying the glass is always half full versus half empty. It's better to say it's magic. It's really magical. And so if you go into every meeting, every discussion, anything that you meet somebody, just expect even a spark of magic, and that even the 5-minute conversation, the 1-minute conversation will be so much better. Be it your driver, be it a guy that you buy stuff from in store, be it anybody, be it mom, be it dad, be it your grandparents, be it anybody. Go there. And the moment you meet them, anybody, every moment, you expect magic. Expect that, and the magic comes from the connection. So if you put all these three things together, if you go forward with enthusiasm, trying to want to make a connection with people, that's where the magic will happen. And you've got to capitalize on that, because that's what life is. Life is just a collection of those magical moments. All your job is to be able to collect as many of those magical moments as you want. And they're not found behind a TV screen or a laptop or an iPad screen looking at Netflix. Go out there, make real connections. And I tell you not, I'm not kidding you. I'm a guy who's a computer geek. And the last 2 months, I haven't on an average looked at my laptop screen for not more than 20 minutes a day. I am just making sure that either I'm reading or actually meeting people and talking to them. And I am so lucky. I've actually connected and reconnected with some amazing individuals that we'll bring on the show. I'll talk to them. I'll tell you what they said also. And so, and I realized that, wow, what am I missing? So the last 6 months of my life, I've actually been living like this, and it's been superb. And in the last 3 months, I've been the happiest of my life. Just simple foot forward, that every connection is absolutely beautiful and magical. Now, all those things are happy and great, but one thing I want to add and end the conversation off with is that another thing Adam had said, he had mentioned about this bullfighter. His name was Juan Belamonte or something like that. And he quoted him, and this is a life lesson to also keep in mind. And he quoted something, which is, he quoted Henry, Juan Belafonte, Belamonte, I'm sorry, Juan Belamonte. He had said somewhere in one of the books that no life worthy of the name consists of anything more than the continual series of struggles to develop one's character through whatever medium you choose to live your life by, career, school, everything. So understand that life is simply a continual series of internal struggles to develop your character. And that matters, because the name, then your name matters. A point that is very well highlighted by a brilliant movie I saw last month or this month. It was called Molly's Game. And Molly's reasoning for doing what she did, not revealing names, if you've seen that movie, was that my name is all I have. And the name is all you have defines your character. And the character is built not by one action, by continual steps of actions that define your work and your life. It doesn't matter what work you do. It's the craft and that you do it with, the care and the character you develop over time with it. Because that is infinite. People will always remember someone's character. And this is so important, because we've seemed to become a nation where that is being lacking. So you guys are the future. The most important thing you can do in life is to have a vision and an idea of what your character needs to be like, or what you want to be remembered by. And that has got to do nothing with money and friends and money. And I said money again because that's what people define it by. It's about you and your character. That's important. That'll be keeping you, that'll keep you rich beyond money. And you cannot undervalue that. And I'm telling you this. It's character. So I hope what I've shared with you, and this is not my stuff, by the way. This is just some really smart people saying some really awesome things. And I'm back. And I'll be definitely be talking to you guys much, much more than I did. I took a long break. The next episode, I shall tell you what was I doing with the last 3 months of my life. But thank you so much. If you're listening to this, you didn't give up. Thanks. Ciao.